So here we are, we're going to do an introduction about Broadcast News, which is a movie directed by James L. Brooks and starring William Hurt, Holly Hunter, and Albert Brooks. The movie is from 1987. It was nominated for 7 Academy Awards. It's part of the Criterion Collection. So we're going to do a review on the film, and you guys are going to see why I like so much of this film.
First time I've seen you dressed like this. You look so clean and pretty.
What do you mean? Clean?
Well, at the office, you always have a sort of film over you.
I've got to find someone. It's important. Excuse me.
Welcome! My name is Daniel Nobre, I'm your host, and this is Cinema Inc., the channel for the fans of the Criterion Collection, international films, art films, and American classics. Please enjoy the channel. And here it is. This is Pine number 552 from the Criterion Collection, and comes also with 28 pages booklet that shows full of pictures. These are the young actors that portrayed the main three actors. Just they appear at the beginning of the film. Okay, nice booklet. Lines and Deadlines by Kerry Hickey. Read this, it's really cool. Her review on the film. Look how cool is that. All right, let's talk about the extras on the film. New, restored, high definition, digital transfer, supervised and approved by director James L. Brooks and editor Richard Marx, then also provide the commentary on the film. James L. Brooks, A Singular Voice, a new documentary on Brooks' career in television and film, featuring actresses Mary Lou Henner and Julie Kavner, among other collaborators. The alternate ending and deleted scenes with commentary by Brooks. New video interview with veteran CBS News producer Susan Zrinsky, one of the models for actress Holly Hunter's character and an associate producer on this film. Featurette containing on-set footage and interviews with Brooks, Hunter, and actor Albert Brooks. Okay, folks, so here we are again to introduce Broadcast News with the, I must say, the beautiful music by Bill Conti, the brilliant screenplay by director James L. Brooks, all make this movie for me a plus from the 80s. There's no mistakes here. This movie really, really is charming. The storyline is there. Maybe to a certain level reminds me His Girl Friday from 1940s, directed by Howard Hanks. In a certain level, of course. But it's better well-developed, the screenplay, and more up-to-date to the 80s. But however, I think the story is timeless because it really, what goes on behind the working place, it reflects what you see today anywhere if you work in that kind of environment. Now, I like journalism because I work for a newspaper myself, and is amazing how the vibe, what goes on behind the scene is well portrayed in this film. I think it's just, you know, it's amazing, and that's why I like this movie so much. I don't think this movie aged. Matter of fact, I think remains very contemporary to a certain degree. Of course, the technology we have today, that changed. But the newsroom itself, if you work for a big network, or even at a small scale network, I think the vibe when the news comes and you gotta put it in the newspaper or goes to television, breaking news. So the excitement about it and the demands of the reporters and the people that work for the press is well pictured in this film. The performers are amazing. All three got Oscar nominations for this. And it's just unbelievable the director didn't get a nomination. The movie was nominated for 7 Academy Awards, but not Best Director, which is unbelievable. However, the screenplay is the key on my view right here, because it's just genius. It really is genius. Now, I like the characters. If you look the kind of William Hurt portrays here, he was a top actor in the 80s. I don't remember seeing him in a bad movie during the 80s. He was, really a leading man in the 80s. All his movies almost all worth it. And this one in particular, I like it because he brings the kind of wise guy softness to the role, and he embodies the character of the anchor itself. Not a guy that knows what goes behind the scenes and goes there he understands the vehicle, but he's not the main guy. For instance, like the character I like even more, Albert Brooks. I really love Albert Brooks in this film. And it's Albert Brooks for me that has the most interesting part in this movie. His part is tragic comic. He's an accomplished writer, he's an achieved reporter, he wants to be anchorman, but he doesn't have what it takes. However, he's the portrayed here, the kind of character, he's the second best. Never the main guys, he's the second option, almost like you have in your car the spare tire. He's that kind of guy, unfortunately, but he's the comic relief in here. And of course, Holly Hunter is brilliant because it was in a year when the women were getting power and working places in conditions that they were in charge of the departments and big companies. And right here, she is the boss, basically. She's brilliant. And they will develop a strange love triangle that is funny to watch, brilliant to understand, and sad to see the tragic moments they go through it. However, that's human nature, and I think that's the brilliance of this film. I recommend that you watch this film. The Criterion Collection has the best of this film because all the extra features that I mentioned before are there and enhances the viewing experience for all of us. And again, at the end of this video, I can't thank you enough for watching this review and to being a member of my channel. Thank you very much. Our numbers are growing, and I can't stress how much is important for me to continue doing this, and your support is key on this. Of course, you know that. So please leave your likes in there if you like this video, and subscribe to the channel if you didn't, and we'll be posting very soon new movie reviews from the Criterion Collection. Okay? Thanks for watching. I'm Daniel Nobre.